Hey guys, welcome to Get Busy Watching. I'm your host, Honest Dan. I'm a little sick. I'll be sipping some tea. Let's talk movies.
This is Detective Muldoon.
This is Peter Spencer. Something happened to me at 44 Rayburn Drive.
Hello?
I went to the house.
Hello? Police department.
Followed me home.
Mommy, what's going on? What's wrong?
We need to leave right now.
Ooh-wee, we are starting 2020 off with a doozy. A semi-continuation, semi-reboot of the popular Japanese films Ju-on. How do I know this? This movie references them. Not the American adaptations with Sarah Michelle Gellar, but the OG Ju-on films. It means nothing. Although, this movie does take place in 2005, so maybe that's its lazy way of connecting itself to those movies as well? Or is this supposed to be a reboot of the 2005 remake? Suffice it to say, it's an awful movie. But I mean, what else do you expect out of a horror film that's released in January or February? These are the months where horror films come out to die, either critically or financially. But what makes it so bad? For one thing, it has no idea what story it wants to tell. On the one hand, we have Detective Muldoon and her son, and we're led to believe she's the star. Then we follow some cuckoo assists in suicides. Then we're following John Cho and Lady Liberty. It's a hodgepodge of stories that are so loosely interconnected that even when the payoff comes, it's either something we saw coming miles away or barely means anything, even in the context of the story. Even the curse makes no real sense. So an opening text says, if you die really angry, a curse is born. Okay, so if you enter a cursed house, it drives you insane, you kill your loved ones and yourself. So, why am I seeing the ghost of a dead girl and this dead woman who were victims of the curse? I'm going to take a wild guess and say that they didn't die angry. Does the curse turn its victims into curses? Nothing in this flick makes a lick of sense. It's just one excuse after another to show one spooky thing after another for no rhyme or reason. Sure, it gives me a reason to plug an ear once or twice, but the scares are cheap and shallow. It's so sad, too, because the actors are trying their hardest. Betty Gilpin plays a pregnant woman who might give birth to a sick baby, and she and John Cho really give it their all. Not a bad drama, all things considered, but people paid for a horror movie, not a downer drama. But then again, the horror is abysmal, so maybe the drama should be what you cling to. For almost half the movie, maybe more than half, there wasn't even a single scare to be found. It was just a lot of talking about the spooky stuff. It's extremely lame. Andrea Riseborough deserves so much better. Overall, yeah, it's a January horror film. What did we expect? It's here for a reason, not because it's good. So it's not worth getting mad at, it's not worth getting upset over, it's just, it's here, it exists, who cares? My honest rating for The Grudge, a 2 out of 5. Thanks so much for watching, you guys, I really appreciate it. Have a great day, hope to see you soon.